Mark Sloan is a womanizer and shows little regard for girls' feelings.
I've been hitting on you all day.
Oh, really? Oh. Excuse me.
It was a stupid idea. It wasn't even my idea. It was Shepard's idea.
Ah, come on.
That woman is not a single malt scotch, my friend. She is bad, cheap wine that gives you a headache you can feel in your teeth.
Mark tries to rekindle his friendship with Derek for his own benefit, but also because he cares about making things right between them.
Mark's superego shows when he genuinely admits that he's in love with Lexi.
I love you.
You don't have to say it just because I said it.
I love you. I've always been in love with you. I will always be in love with you.
Yeah.
Which is why you have to stay alive. We're going to get married. Two or three kids.
So Thea can have siblings.
Yeah, a sister and two brothers.
That's nice.
We're gonna be happy, Lex. You and me. We're gonna have the best life, Lexi, you and me. We're gonna be so happy. So you can't die, okay?
Mark Sloan is consciously aware of his flaws as a person.
It's because behind this rugged and confident exterior, I'm self-destructive and self-loathing to an almost pathological degree.
Hey.
Mark can admit to his affair with Addison and that it was wrong of him.
When Mark was on his deathbed, he became very optimistic despite the fact that the love of his life died and that he was about to also.
Just the way she is, and if she believes you, you save someone unnecessary surgical procedure.
And that is definitely not how I talk to a patient.
No, but it's how you talk to a woman, Avery. We're in the business of making people feel better about themselves.
Again, sometimes when you talk, I feel like a male prostitute.
She's a person on the precipice of change, Avery. She's scared and she's worried. God, the things we worry about, so pointless. And we get to help take that worry away. It's why we're doctors.
Mark grew up with permissive parents that were never really around, so he considered Derek's mother to be like his mom because she cared about what he did with his life, unlike his own parents.
Mark has a lot of sexual interest in women. Mark's controlling tendencies show when he flies from New York to Seattle to convince Addison to be with him.
Rationalization. When Lexi is dying, he doesn't want to believe that she's dying, so he tries to rationalize that she won't die.
Meredith, that I love her, and that she's a good sister. Please, tell my dad.
You're not dying. You're gonna be fine.
Hold my hand.
I'm not holding your hand because you're not dying.
Hold my hand.
No, you're not dying. Do you hear me? You don't die today.
Reaction formation. Mark doesn't admit to his feelings for Lexi or show emotions towards her, even though he feels the same way as her.
And he's younger than you, and he doesn't have any grandkids or babies with his lesbian BFFs, and he's in Avery, and he liked me. You know, he really liked me. But it was never going to work out, because I love you. I am so in love with you. And you're in me. It's you're like, it's
Regression. As Lexi is dying, Mark is sitting next to her crying and holding her hand in a childlike way.
Considering that neither of his parents were really around during his childhood, he didn't have any feelings of jealousy toward his father or desire for his mother. His Oedipus complex did not exist.